Hi dear student, good morning. Welcome to English class. In the previous class, we have completed the first lesson of Unit 4. I think you have read that lesson well. I think you could understand the lesson well. Today, we are going to take some activities. The first one, activity 7, page number 118. Take your textbook page number 118. Activity 7. Read the words given in the bubble. Find out words that are related to the encircled word. Write them in the blanks given. They have given some words in a bubble. Perfume, scent, sight, sweet, sour, whisper, noise, look. And some words they have encircled there. That is, see, hear, smell, taste. The activity is find out words that are related to the encircled word from the bubble. Bubble ninnum encircle cheyda words mai relate cheyna words eduthu ezhuthuka. The first one, see. What are the words related with C from the bubble? Or in the bubble, what are the words related with the C? Tell me. Sight. Sight is related with the C. Sight means kaalcha. Next one, look. Look also related with the C. Nokuka. ഒക്കെ കാണുക നോക്കുക കാഴ്ച അതൊക്കെ റിലേറ്റഡ് ആണ് അപ്പോ സീ സൈറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ലുക്ക് ദീസ് ആർ ദ വേർഡ്സ് റിലേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഈച്ച് അദർ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ ഹിയർ കേൾക്കുക വാട്ട് ആർ ദ വേർഡ്സ് റിലേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഇറ്റ് ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് യുവർ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക് ആൻഡ് ടെൽ മീ വാട്ട് ആർ ദ വേർഡ്സ് റിലേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഹിയർ കേൾവിയുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട വാക്കുകൾ ഏതൊക്കെ പറയൂ ഫ്രം ദി ബബിൾ വൺ വേർഡ് ഇസ് ദ നോയ്സ് വാട്ട് ഇസ് മീൻ ബൈ നോയ്സ് ശബ്ദം നോയ്സ് ഇസ് റിലേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഹിയർ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ വിസ്പർ വാട്ട് ഇസ് മീൻ ബൈ വിസ്പർ വിസ്പർ മീൻസ് പിറുപിറുക്കുക അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മന്ത്രിക്കുക എന്നൊക്കെ അർത്ഥം ദാറ്റ് ഓൾസോ റിലേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഹിയർ ദ വേർഡ് ഹിയർ ഓക്കെ ദെൻ ഹിയർ Whisper and noise. These are the words related with each other. Third one, smell. The next word is smell. The next word is smell. What are the words related with smell? Tell me. Smell. Any other keywords related to smell? My perfume and scent. Perfume scent. Okay. Smell my related to words. Smell related the word perfume and scent. Next one, taste. What are the words related with taste? Taste. Ruji. Sweet and sour. Sweet and sour. Related with the word taste. Okay, that is activity 7. Once more, listen. The words related with see, sight, and look. The words related with hear, whisper, and noise. The words related with smell, perfume, and scent. Then, related with the taste, sweet and sour. Okay. Next one, activity 7. Use of hardly. Next one, activity 7. So, activity 8, use of hardly. Do you know what is mean by hardly? I think this word is familiar to you, but do you know the meaning of hardly? Hardly means almost not. ഒരു നോട്ട് എന്ന മീനിങ് വരുന്ന ഒരു വേർഡ് ആണ് ഹാർഡ്ലി അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു നെഗറ്റീവ് മീനിങ് തരുന്ന ഒരു വേർഡ് ആണ് ഹാർഡ്ലി By using this word, we can rewrite the sentences. We can give the negative meaning to the sentences by using hardly. So hardly means almost not. Not in the meaning of hardly. Okay. Then how can we use hardly? That is the next activity we are going to do. Rewrite the sentences by using hardly. The first one. The old man was so deaf that he could not hear what the king said. It is a negative sentence. How can we understand it is a negative sentence? It is a negative sentence. How can we understand that? Because in this sentence, not is used. So, not to be used in this sentence is a negative sentence. Okay. Then, we have to rewrite this sentence by the use of hardly. Hardly be able to use this sentence in this meaning. Without changing the meaning. Meaning in the meaning of this sentence is rewrite by the use of hardly. Okay. How can you do this? The old man was so deaf that he could not hear what the king said. Already I have told you that hardly means not. So instead of not, we can use hardly. Not in the bagala namke endu upayogikkam? Hardly upayogikkam. Engane change varam? Engane ee sentence ne relate cheyam? Okku. The old man was so deaf that he could hardly hear. He could not hear ennathinu pagaram endu upayogikkam? He could hardly hear what the king said. Could not ennathinu pagaram could hardly. Could hardly um could not um same meaning aanu. Appo aa sentence ne meaning il yaadoru change varada namukku ee sentence ne rewrite cheyyam. I think it's clear. Okay. Hardly means not. Like almost not and the meaning aanu hardly ki varunathu. Okay. Oru sentence il negative meaning tharunna word ne pagaram namukku endu upayogikkam hardly upayogikkam. Negative meaning there are some words. What are the words? Yes. No, not, never, nothing, none. Look at that. Negative meaning there are some words. What are the words? Hardly. So we can rewrite the sentences without changing the meaning. Okay.
The old man was so deaf that he could not hear what the king said.
Is it? Change meaning maarada maatiyada engenaanu.
The old man was so deaf that he could not
in pagaram he could hardly ennaaki. He could hardly hear what the king said. Not in pagaram hardly upayogichu. Okay, is it clear? Then
second one. The wise man thought for a long time but couldn't make head or tail of it. The wise man thought for a long time but couldn't make head or tail of it.
It is also a negative sentence because here couldn't. Here used couldn't. Could not again used couldn't. So it's a negative sentence.
As like the first one, we can change this also like the wise man thought for a long time but
could hardly make head or tail of it. I'm going to change it around. Could hardly make head or tail of it. I'm going to match it now. Right? In your textbook now itself.
The wise man thought for a long time but could hardly make head or tail of it.
Okay. Third one.
The learned man pondered again and searched in their books, but couldn't find anything about it. The learned man pondered again and searched in their books, but couldn't find anything about it.
As like the previous one, how can we change it?
Yes, the learned man pondered again and searched in their books, but
instead of couldn't, we can use could hardly find anything about it. Could hardly find anything about it. Then, move to the last one. We knew nothing of money in our old days. We knew nothing of money in our old days. Is it a negative sentence? Is it a negative sentence? Yes, it's a negative sentence. How can we understand that? നമുക്ക് അത് എങ്ങനെ അറിയാം? ഇതൊരു negative sentence ആണെന്ന് എങ്ങനെ മനസ്സിലായി? Because in this sentence, one word, that is nothing, is used. Nothing is giving negative meaning, so it's a negative sentence. Then how can we use a hardly here in the last sentence? Tell me. Yes, we knew, instead of nothing we can use the hardly. We knew hardly of money in our old days. We knew nothing in our end ubayikkam, hardly ubayikkam. We knew hardly of money in our old days. Okay, I think you could understand this activity well. But it's remember hardly. Hardly means not. So instead of not or instead of negative meaning, we can use hardly. We can rewrite some sentences by using hardly without changing its meaning for giving negative meaning. Okay, that is the use of hardly. Move to the next activity. Activity 9. Read the following sentences from the story. The grain was as large as a hen's egg. This is already given in your textbook. That's the sentence. The grain was as large as a hen's egg. Grain, എങ്ങനെയുള്ള grain ആയിരുന്നു? Yes, ഒരു ഹെന്നിന്റെ egg പോലെ ഉള്ള grain ആയിരുന്നു. അപ്പോ ആ grainനെ എന്തുമായി കമ്പയർ ചെയ്തു? ഹെന്നിന്റെ eggമായിട്ട് കമ്പയർ ചെയ്തു. For comparing same quality of two things, two persons, we can use as means pole. അതായത് രണ്ട് വ്യക്തികളുടെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ രണ്ട് വസ്തുക്കളുടെ ഒക്കെ ഒരേ ഗുണങ്ങളെ കമ്പയർ ചെയ്ത് പറയാൻ നമുക്ക് എന്ത് ഉപയോഗിക്കാം? As ഉപയോഗിക്കാം. Use of as. Okay, for comparing the same quality of two things or two persons, we can use as. Pole in the meaning ആണ് കിട്ടുക. But the grain was as large as a hen's egg എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ grain എങ്ങനെയുള്ള grain ആയിരുന്നു? ഹെൻസിന്റെ egg പോലെ large. അപ്പോ അവിടുത്തെ ഒരു ക്വാളിറ്റി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് grainും large ആണ്, ഹെന്നിന്റെ eggും large ആണ് അല്ലെ. അപ്പോ ആ ലാർജ് എന്ന ക്വാളിറ്റി, രണ്ടു പേർക്കും ലാർജ് എന്നൊരു ക്വാളിറ്റി ഉണ്ട്, അതിനെ കമ്പയർ ചെയ്യാനായിട്ട് ഉപയോഗിച്ച വേർഡ് ആണ് as. Okay, then how can we split the sentence? ഈ സെന്റൻസിനെ നമ്മൾ ഒന്ന് സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് നോക്കിയാൽ, the grain was large, a hen's egg was large. ഗ്രെയിനും ലാർജ് ആണ്, ഹെന്നിന്റെ എഗ്ഗും ലാർജ് ആണ്. അപ്പൊ ആ ലാർജ് എന്ന ആ ക്വാളിറ്റി നമ്മൾ as ഉപയോഗിച്ച് നമ്മൾ കമ്പയർ ചെയ്ത് പറയുന്നു. കമ്പയർ ചെയ്ത് പറയുന്നു. ഓക്കെ, then one box is given there. We have to combine the sentences by using as. Okay, the first one, Kishore is tall. The next box, Anand is tall too. Kishore is tall means Kishore nalla tall aanu, adu pole Anandu tall aanu. Appo what is the quality there? Tall enna ക്വാളിറ്റി, ടു പേഴ്സൺസിന്റെ ടോൾ എന്ന ക്വാളിറ്റിയെ നമ്മൾ കമ്പയിൻ ചെയ്ത് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ കമ്പയർ ചെയ്ത് പറയണം. എങ്ങനെ പറയാം? ബൈ യൂസിംഗ് ആസ്. യെസ്, കിഷോർ ഈസ് ആസ് ടോൾ ആസ് ആനന്ദ്. ലിസണ്, കിഷോർ ഈസ് ആസ് ടോൾ ആസ് ആനന്ദ്. കിഷോർ ആനന്ദിനെ പോലെ ടോൾ ആണ്. പോലെ എന്ന മീനിങ് ആണ് ഇവിടെ ആസസ് കൊണ്ട് വന്നിട്ടുള്ളത്. ആസസ് ഉപയോഗിച്ച് കിട്ടിയ മീനിങ് എന്താണ്? പോലെ.
Kishore Anandine pole tall aanu. Kishore is as tall as Anand. Kishore Anandine pole tall aanu. Is it clear? Kishore is as tall as Anand. I think clear. Next one. Nitin is young. Nitin is young. Atul is also young. Quality young. Young is a quality though. Rendu perum young aanu. Nitinum young aanu. Atulum young aanu. How can we combine the sentences by using an as a? Yes. Nitin is as young as Atul. Nitin is as young as Atul. Nitin Atulne pole yengaanu. Nitinum yengaanu, Atulum yengaanu. Appo Nitin Atulne pole yengaanu. Nitin is as young as Atul. Third one. Tintu Luka runs fast. Tintu Luka runs fast. A deer also runs fast. A deer also runs fast. What is the quality there? Runs fast. Alle? Nannayi vegathil odunnu ennaanu adutha quality. Rendu vyaktikalude. Allengil oru deerinte Tintu Luka. Rendu pere nammal compare cheyanam. Engane parayam? Tintu Luka runs as fast as a deer. Tintu Luka runs as fast as a deer. Tintu Luka runs as fast as a deer. Oru deer ne pole fast aayi odunnu. Okay. Next one. A jasmine is beautiful. A jasmine is beautiful. A lotus is also beautiful. So the quality is the beautiful and learn of the quality. How can we combine? A jasmine is as beautiful as a lotus. Oru jasmine endu pole manoharamana, oru lotusine pole manoharam. Appo jasmine beautiful aanu, lotusum beautiful aanu. Appo jasmine endu pole manoharamana, a jasmine is as beautiful as a lotus. Oru jasmine alle lotus pole manoharamana. Next one. A grain is small. A grain is small. And ant is small too. A grain is small. And ant is small too. Very simple. Yes. A grain is as small as an ant. Oru grain ennu parayunnathu oru antine pole cheruthaanu. A grain is as small as an ant. Okay? Understood? Okay. Then, one more thing is under. It all. Tall, young, fast, beautiful, small. What is the specialty of this word? Ee vaakkalude pratheekathakal enda? Tell me. What are the specialties of this word? What is the specialty of this word? Tall, young, fast, beautiful, small. These are adjectives. These are adjectives. Alle? Adjectives ilu padichittulladu alle neengal? Alle? Kazhinja classukalile okku padichittulladana. Adjectives are the words used to describe the nouns. Nouns in a describe yana ubayogikkunna words aanu adjectives. Appo ee adjectives ubayogichu nammal ezhuthumbo adinte idayil varunnathu eppozhum endayirikkum adjectives thanneyayirikkum. Okay. Understand? Okay. Then that is today's class. Activity 7, 8 and 9 I have completed. I think you also completed your textbook. Then if you have any doubt, ask me. Let's meet in the next class. Let's wind up now. Thank you. Bye.